I created an Excel add-in called XLlama. It lets you run large language models right inside Excel for free. So you can download and use any open source models like DeepSeek, Llama, Mistral, and a bunch of more. The important part is that those models run locally on your machine. So no spreadsheet data is leaving your computer, and that also means you can use the add-in without any internet connection. Now you might be wondering, why would I even use AI in Excel? So in this video I'm going to show you some example use cases. And after seeing those, I'm pretty sure you will also come up with your own ideas for how to use AI in your daily spreadsheet task. Now XLlama works also on older versions of Excel, like 2016 for example, and you can use it on Windows and even macOS. The only thing you need is a desktop version of Excel, because the add-in uses VBA under the hood, so the web version won't work. Alright, so that is enough of an intro, I guess. Let us jump right in and let me show you the add-in and also some use cases. Alright, so once you install the add-in, you will have a new Excel formula and it's called XLlama prompt. And you might have guessed that already, here you can now enter your prompt. For example, you can ask it the most discussed question in human history. Is Excel a database? Answer in one sentence. Alright, and once you press enter, it might take a second or two. And then you will get back the result right in Excel. So here it says Excel is not a traditional database. Well, we all know that's not true. And if you disagree, let me know in the comments. All right, this is like the basic idea. So you have a new Excel formula called XLlama prompt where you can enter your prompt. So now moving forward, I have prepared a little bit more useful examples. For example, extracting names, phone numbers, emails, and so on and so forth. So let's go through each of them one by one. So let's start by extracting the name. So the idea here is that I have my prompt in this cell here, and I've got my example text. Now I could of course also go ahead and type in my prompt directly in here, but this format will save us a little bit of time. So my prompt is extract all the full names from the text, use comma if there's multiple names, and return NA if there's no name found. And then I've got my text. So since this is just like a normal Excel formula, I can also combine my text here, so which is my prompt in A2, and I will combine it with my text in B2. And when I press enter, I will get the result right in Excel, and I can also drag it down just like a normal Excel formula. Okay, so let's see what we've got here. So Peter and his manager James joined the meeting late, so we've got James and Peter. Then we've got only Lisa. Here our team completed the task successfully and sent the report, so there's no name, so that's the reason we've got an A. Then we've got Michael and Sarah, and in the last example there's no name, so we got an A back. Alright, so this works. And now for the next examples, I will just copy this formula, because the layout is exactly the same in this spreadsheet. So let me paste it right in here, and this time the prompt is extract the phone numbers from the text, no preamble, output only the number, and here's my text. And also notice here it's all in different formats, so let's see what we get as a result. So when I drag it down, we will now get back all the phone numbers in the cells here. Now of course you could also do it with Excel formulas, but this might take a little bit longer for you to find the right formula and then also to format the numbers, because you can of course also extend my prompt a little bit further and say that you want to have the numbers formatted in a specific way. So keep that in mind, this is just like one example. Okay. Next, moving forward, let's do the same, but this time let's extract some emails. So let me copy it down here. And as we can see here, it now extracted all the emails from my text here. Alright, so far so good. Let's move on to another example, and this time is a little bit different. So we want to convert the given number into English words and output only the full written form, not the digits, and here's my number. So 128, so that's correct. And again, I will just copy down the formula. Then we've got 101, 404, 3250, that's also correct, and 12. Alright, now again, let's copy this text here, and let's move on to a more classical example, translating some text. So here I've got the English version, and I would like to have it to translate it to German. So we've got the first text, good morning, how can I help you? Guten Morgen, wie kann ich Ihnen helfen? Yep, that's correct, and I can also see the translation for the other text here. Alright, next up, let's do some sentiment analysis. So again, I will just paste in the formula in here. And here I've got an example review. I love the new update, it's amazing. And what I do, I want to have the sentiment of the review. So it could be either positive, neutral, or negative. So this one, it's clearly positive, that's correct. And if I drag it down, we will also get back the result for the other examples. So here we've got the customer support was terrible and unhelpful. Yeah, that's negative. And it's okay, it's not the best, it's not bad either. Yeah, that's a neutral one. Okay, and with that, let's move on to the last example, which is fixing some grammar and spelling mistakes. And also if I drag it down here, we will get back the result right in our spreadsheet. And once you get your result, you can also convert it to values. So this makes sense if you don't want to rerun all the formulas again. So let me show you what I mean. So here I will just select my first two cells and then I go to the convert XLlamas to formulas and I convert the formula in my current selection. So if I do this, I can now see that the formula is now converted to text. And I could also do this in the active sheet like this. So once I confirm it, also the other formulas are now converted. And again, I could also do it for the entire workbook. So I can see here now that 31 formulas have been replaced. And also we can check this, for example, in the translation. This is now all text. Now, so far we've used only the XLlama prompt formula, but if you wanted to, you can also analyze an entire range. So for example, here I've got a financial report with the month, the product, the sales and the profit. So what I can do here, I can just select the entire range and then click the Run XLlama button. This will now open an input box where you can enter your prompt. So there's already a default, for example, extract the key insights from my data in one sentence, no preamble, and once I hit OK, this data will be sent to the AI and you will get back the result in a new sheet. So here we now have our XLlama output sheet and here I can also see the result. Now I have to say you've got to be a little bit careful with this feature. It works, but only if you feed it with a small range of cells. So if you try to do it with hundreds or thousands of cells, the result is not really the best. And if it's something like this, where you have like a financial report, you might actually do want to cross-check the result because the AI can do mistakes. So I just want to be upfront here. Use this feature carefully. All right, and with that now, you have seen the main features of the XLlama add-in. Now, the cool thing is that you can install and use any models you want, which are available on ollama. I will talk about ollama in just a second, but here you can see currently I've used the Llama 3 model, but if I wanted to, I can also use DeepSeek or Mistral. And the cool thing is, all those AI models are running locally on your machine, so no data is ever leaving your computer and you don't have to pay for anything. Now, if you want to install more models, you can go to the ollama website, which I have open here, and you will see there are a ton of models you can choose from. And once again, you can install all those models for free. So for example, here I will install the Gemma 3M model, which is designed for efficient execution on everyday devices such as laptops, tablets or phones. So I think this sounds perfect for XLlama. And all you need to do here is to just grab the model name. So you just copy it to your clipboard and then I will open a terminal. It's right over here. And here I can type ollama pull and paste in the model name I just copied and press enter. And now we will pull the model from the internet and install it on your machine so that you can also use it then with XLlama. And while this is downloading, let me actually explain the concept behind the XLlama add-in. So the XLlama add-in is what you install in Excel and it will use under the hood ollama. Now ollama is a free and open source software that lets you download, like we're doing here, and run large language model right on your computer. And the keyword here, it's free and open source, so you don't have to pay for it. And then once you have ollama installed and set up and downloaded a model, you can use that model inside the XLlama add-in. Now, and if that sounds a little bit complicated, don't worry. I've created like an entire documentation that explains everything in more detail. And here you can also see how to install ollama, how to install XLlama, how to use a terminal on Windows and on macOS, and all the things you need to get up and running in no time. Alright, and now we'll just wait until the model is downloaded. Alright, so this is done now and the cool thing is you don't have to do anything else because this model we just downloaded is now available in Excel. So for that I just go to my settings and here if I go on the drop down menu I can now see the new model which is Gemma 3N. I can select it and by the way you can also input your system default prompt here. So here it currently says that you are a helpful assistant integrated into Microsoft Excel, no preamble and only return the final result. But if you wanted to, you can also change it. For example, reply in the style of Super Mario. Alright, so let me save it. And now we can give it a try. For that, let's ask the same question again. So is Excel a database? Answer in one sentence. Alright, and then we get back the result. And I can already see this is now in the Super Mario style. So we've got like here the emojis in here. And woohoo, you can do things with it, but it's not a database for bigger or more organized stuff. Alright, so now if you want to get started with XLlama and you want to use it in, you just head over to my website and it will be the first link in the description box below. So here you will also see there's a free and also a paid version available. Now the free version obviously has some limitations, for example how many XLlama prompt formulas you can use in one sheet. So have a look at my website and once you download it, you will get a welcome email. And in that welcome email, as I mentioned, there will be like a link to the getting started video to get you up and running in no time. So once again, as I said, everything runs locally on your machine. So that means if you wanted to, you can also turn off your internet and the XLlama prompt formula will still work. Also, you don't have to pay for any API calls or whatsoever. So yeah, as I said, if you want to download it, check the first link in the description box below. And now I'm really curious, what do you think about it in? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video. Cheers!